Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Folks, Paul Watson is with us recapping the Ukraine situation. I'm going to come back, get into a bunch of news we haven't hit yet, and go to your phone calls, as I said. I have told you this from the beginning because it's publicly known fact. It's just I would say it and people would laugh at me. In fact, I was rereading a hit piece they did on me. Was it Psychology Today or was it the New York Times I ran across last night? And they were making jokes, it was like 4 or 5 years ago, that Alex Jones thinks the internet is run by DARPA and the CIA. And he also thinks the sky's blue at high noon. And he also thinks Tweety Birds tweet. And he also thinks fish swim in the ocean. And he also thinks plants need carbon dioxide. And everyone knows you need to pay Al Gore for that. Putin, the internet is a CIA project. Russia needs greater control. I mean, there's just so much truth keeps coming out of Putin. And you know why? I'm not saying Putin's perfect. He certainly has problems. He knows everybody already knows everything. Why lie about everything? That's another big question. Paul, why do you think the Western media, the controlled press, has turned up the lies in the face of their lies being exposed? Are they trying to just acclimate us in a learned helplessness with a solid array of lies to set the precedent with titration dose, with social inoculation, where we just accept lies as the new ether in which we exist?
I think it's more simple than that. I think it's simply because they know they can get away with it. I mean, for example, look at the Turkish situation a few weeks ago. It came out admittedly that they were planning a false flag attack against their own target, the territory that they occupy in Syria. And that's the reason why they banned YouTube. Now, the mass of the Western mainstream media reported that Turkey had banned YouTube. But only one of them, from what I saw, which was USA Today, actually told us why they had banned YouTube, because this false flag revelation, top military officials, political officials planning that false flag attack, was contained in the YouTube video. That's why the Turkish government banned YouTube. But because the mainstream media doesn't report the key aspect of a story, most people remain completely bewildered about the geopolitical situation as regards Turkey and Syria. So they know that most of the people watching don't have any kind of depth of knowledge about any of these subjects whatsoever. So when they do get caught lying, they simply don't care. They simply go on. I mean, what happened to the leaked audio tape about the fact that it was Ukraine that was behind the snipers in Kiev killing protesters? Again, the Victoria Nuland tape where they were plotting who to install in the puppet government. Both came out in the media, both disappeared within days when they should have been major scandals for weeks. So again, it's this power that they have when they act in unison. Individually, the media is declining, they're losing their audience, but they all act in unison, they get behind major talking points, and that's how they're able to hold their influence over the public discourse.
Paul, what's your gut? I want to come back and spend a few more minutes with you on this. I want you to think about this now. Because we get this type of societal fatigue with all this corruption and evil. And the establishment does too. They get kind of a blind spot when they're insulated from repercussions. And that's how you get World War I, World War II. That's how you get the big European wars between Napoleon and the UK, the Brits at the time. And not just me, all these mainline historians, as you know, when I say all, they're just all over the news, are saying, looks like a world war, looks like what you see before a global meltdown, the economy, the derivatives, the debts, the social corruption, prepare for fireworks. And it won't just be with war, it'll be with superbugs are now peaking and societal collapse and debt and civil wars and just Arab Springs, American Springs, all sorts of hell breaking loose. We'll be right back. I want to see where Paul thinks this is going, A, and B, how do we stop this war?
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee. And it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
The globalist social engineers are not just targeting us with propaganda. They are manipulating our genetics. We are being targeted at every level by estrogen mimickers that lower our testosterone and other hormones and natural compounds that the body needs. After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic super male vitality formula, sourced from powerful organic herbs and then concentrated for maximum potency. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose. For a limited time, we are offering 15% off Super Male Vitality at InfoWarsLife.com to introduce you to this powerful supplement. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality. InfoWarsLife.com.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosates that is found in water supply worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll free 888-253-3139.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Slovyansk has Russian Hind helicopters controlled by the Western-controlled Ukrainian government flying over it. Tanks and armored vehicles and troops have come into the city. There's smoke and reported dead. Explosions are still going off as they take over the government buildings of the predominantly ethnic Russian city. And we had Lavrov, we'll cue that up from yesterday and play that in a minute, the foreign minister, saying that if Russian ethnic areas are attacked, Russia will respond, quote, just like they did in Georgia, in South Ossetia and Abkhazia. We're going to cue that clip up from yesterday where he put it out in English to warn people. This is a very serious situation. In fact, before we get Watson's take, reporting from London on where he thinks this is all going and can a wider war be stopped, which again the globalists want to use as a pretext to get even more banker bailout money to, quote, stabilize Europe in a new Marshall Plan. That's the George Soros project. That's his own words. Let's go to this clip of the Russian foreign minister yesterday.
If we are attacked, we would certainly respond. If our interests legitimate interests, the interests of Russians, have been attacked directly, like they were in Southeast Asia, for example. I don't see any other way but to respond in full accordance with international law. Russian citizens being attacked is an attack against the Russian Federation. The only thing I would like to highlight at this stage is that the Russian troops are on the Russian territory. The requests for inspections under the so-called Vienna document of 2011 and under the Treaty of the Open Sky, they all have been granted. The inspectors visited the areas of deployment of the troops participating in the training exercises. The planes overflight the areas of exercise, and no one who participated in the inspections, including the Americans, Ukrainians, and Europeans, ever brought up any fact which would indicate that Russia was engaged in some dangerous military activity.
But, Lavrov, they did bring up photoshopped images of Russian troops attacking people, which they now admit the New York Times is fake. And they did find WMDs, New York Times, that didn't exist in Iraq. And they did make up chemical attacks launched by Assad that turned out to be Al-Qaeda. That's now, the UN even admits that. That's now official, and the Turkish government admits it. And Lavrov, they did, you know, stage attacks on Jews that they blamed on Russians, when everybody knows it's the Western Ukrainians that are Nazis. Not all of them, but the large portion. And so Lavrov, I mean, you know, just shut up. Obama doesn't lie. Hillary doesn't lie. McCain doesn't lie. The CIA director doesn't lie. Obamacare is free. Pigs fly. Now, getting serious here, Russia could attack any minute, rolling in with heavy armor. That's what they're saying they'll do. The question is, do they count this city that's mainly Russian that was moving to vote to be part of Russia? See, even if Russia doesn't want that, the eastern part of Ukraine, even the girl from Fifth Element, Mila Yozovich, I pronounced her name wrong, but she's certainly a beautiful lady. I'm a big fan for a long time. Fifth Element, you name it. I've seen her music, by the way. Kevin Booth went and shot some video for a production of hers. I saw her sing once. That was really nice. Side issue. The point is, she's a listener of ours, and she considers herself Ukrainian, but thinks wrong is what's happening to the Russians, and sends out Watson's articles. That whole eastern area is going to want to go. She's really a fan of Watson, actually. The point is, that whole thing, I'm jealous, Watson, I'm sorry. That whole thing is going to go very, very badly. And they're going to want to go with the Russians. They're not going to want to be under the Kiev ultra-right wing, so right wing, there's National Socialist on record. They're being persecuted. They're being killed. They're being beaten up. They're being shot. And so they're going to respond. It's going to cause a civil war. The West is going to say it's Russia doing it when it's natural ethnic religious lines. The West being mainly Catholic, the East being mainly Orthodox. What does your gut tell you is going to happen? A, B, is there a way to stop this in your view, Watson?
Well, first off, remember the referendum in Crimea. 77% voted in favor of becoming part of the Russian Federation. According to the EU, that was an illegitimate vote, which is interesting because when the people of France, Holland, and Ireland voted against the EU Lisbon Treaty, the EU simply kept having more referendums until they got the answer they wanted. So not exactly the authority in denouncing votes as illegitimate when they do it as a habit. But what's the danger to me is that neocons like Anne-Marie Slaughter, CFR State Department, are now calling for the US to attack Syria as a lesson for Putin. So they're not happy with just Ukraine blowing up. Now they want to expand it even further, talking about going into Syria just to teach Putin a lesson. Where I see it going is by 2018, they're going to have these missile defense bases, these interceptors, which of course are offensive, stationed in Poland and Romania. The Obama administration initially rolled back the previous George W. Bush policy to have them in Czechoslovakia, but now they seem to be committed to this. It could go either way. So over the next 4 years, Russia has made it very clear, numerous top Russian politicians have made it very clear that they see the installation of those missile bases right on their border as a direct attack, and that they will strike back with their missiles. So if they're insane, crazy,